This is chemistry assignment for incoming senior BPC students. Date 07/09/2020. That is September 7th. The topic is chemical reactivity and E naught values. Topic is chemical reactivity and E naught values. In 3D series, which element having large difference in observed and calculated value of SRP values? For two elements, difference is observed for cobalt and nickel. But large difference is observed in case of cobalt. In case of cobalt. That is from graph given in NCERT textbook. Next. Question number 2. E naught value is positive for. E naught value is positive for. E naught value positive only for Cu 2 plus bar Cu, its value also 0.34 volts. Value is 0.34 volts, positive value. Among 3D series, the only element which has positive SRP is copper. Next. Question number 3. The correct order of reducing power of 4 successive elements, chromium, manganese, iron and cobalt. Reducing nature inversely proportional to SRP value. SRP value anta takku unte thanik reducing nature anta ekkuva. Based on that statement, we can conclude the answer as here. Manganese has highest SRP and then chromium. Manganese has highest, next element is chromium, next one iron, and last one is cobalt. Next question number 4. E naught values for couples chromium 3 plus bar chromium 2 plus and Mn 3 plus bar Mn 2 plus were given. The values are -0.41 and +1.51. These values suggest that from electrochemical series, the species with lower SRP can act as reducing agent. The species with a higher SRP can act as oxidizing agent. From this knowledge, we can decide Cr2 plus acts as a reducing agent, whereas Mn2 plus can act as Cr2 plus can act as reducing agent, whereas Mn2 plus can act as oxidizing agent. Once again, I repeat the reason. The species with lower SRP acts as a reducing agent. The species with higher SRP can act as oxidizing agent. Knowledge from electrochemical series. Next question number 5. In a reaction, the ferrous ion is oxidized to ferric. The equivalent weight of ion is... Here, ferrous, Fe2+, converts into ferric. Ferrous converts into ferric. So, here equivalent weight. Equivalent weight is equal to atomic weight by... Equivalent weight is equal to atomic weight by number of electrons transferred. Here charge is plus 2, here plus 1. Number of electrons transferred only 1. So equivalent weight is equal to atomic weight by 1. So equivalent weight is equal to atomic weight in this conversion from ferrous to ferric. Next question number 6th one. Among calcium, potassium, iron, zinc, the element which can form more than one binary compound with chlorine. Binary compound form ayindi ante it shows variable oxidation state. Among the given elements, iron is a transition element which shows variable oxidation states, that is plus 2 and plus 3. So it can able to form two types of compounds, whereas remaining elements are non-transition elements. Next question number 7. Transition element shows paramagnetic behavior due to paramagnetic behavior. Reason for paramagnetic behavior is presence of unpaired electrons. Presence of unpaired electrons in N-1d sublevel. N-1d sublevel lo unpaired electrons unte para, otherwise it is considered as dia. Next question number 8. The maximum oxidation state shown by manganese in its compounds is, manganese shows maximum oxidation number plus 7 in the compound potassium permanganate. In the compound potassium permanganate. In 3D series, the element which shows maximum oxidation number is manganese, that is plus 7 in the compound potassium permanganate. Next question number 9. Which of the following compound is not colored? Not colored means there is no DD transitions. There is no DD transitions means there is no unpaired electron. Unpaired electron absence. So we have to find out the option in which there is no unpaired electron. In the second option, cadmium is in plus 2 oxidation state, which has D10 configuration. D10 configuration means there is no unpaired electrons. There is no unpaired electrons in N-1d sublevel means there is no DD transitions. There is no DD transitions means it cannot able to exhibit the color. And one more reason, we know that zinc, cadmium, mercury are not belonging to transition elements. That's why the elements zinc, cadmium, mercury does not forms colored compounds. Next and last question. The metal ion responsible for Minamata disease is, the metal which is responsible for Minamata disease, that is mercury. Mercury. This is, I think all of you know, it is also in first year syllabus, that is in the chapter Environmental Chemistry. Hg2+ is responsible for Minamata disease. Thank you, students. Thank you.